I'm Sarah Duke.
And I'm Casey Green.
And we both serve with the Apartment Life Ministry here at Watermark.
I am Amy Farrell and serve in West Dallas.
And I am Erin Patrick and I serve in West Dallas.
Apartment Life is a ministry where two people, whether a husband and wife or two singles, are strategically placed in a community, an apartment community, to cultivate friendships among the residents and ultimately, through relational evangelism, bring them to church and just love on them until they ask why. It was put on my heart about a year ago, this ministry for Apartment Life, and I didn't have a teammate. I just kind of knew about the ministry and liked the idea behind it.
And I wanted to participate in this ministry that just helps love on people and help them experience the love of God in their lives. And I just got on fire for it.
And then the wheel just started turning, and 3 months later, we're a care student.
I really feel like the Lord just has really grown our friendship, and we just have a similar heart for a lot of the same people and circumstances and such. Gotten to serve in kind of inner city environments for a long time prior to that.
Just I'd been really praying about a place to serve and just a place to get plugged in and just really start pouring into other people, and just prayed about it a lot and just came across Mercy Street, which is a ministry in West Dallas, just mentoring kiddos, and got involved with that, I guess, maybe 2 years ago, something like that, 2 years ago. And just being involved with the ministry, it's challenging because I was living in Lakewood, which is in East Dallas, and West Dallas is obviously on the west side of town. So trying to get really, you know, trying to build those relationships, I mean, it was tough, you know. There's a pretty big distance between those two areas, and so just really started, I don't know, just felt led to maybe move a little bit closer to the area and remove some of the hurdles to building relationships. And the biggest hurdle that I just really felt was there was just time and space.
Definitely the most memorable experience for me with specifically with the resident would be with this one gentleman who he has come to every single event we've had. He is a believer, and he's just going through a really, really hard time right now, and I just asked him a question following up on something that he'd asked me, mentioned to me a couple of weeks before, and it just opened up the floodgates, and I asked him if we could go pray, and I got one of our male volunteers, and the three of us went back, and he was just so grateful just to have some folks love on him.
There was a lot of objections and a lot of discouragement in this area to actually move, and just the safety aspects, and was this wise?
I think my biggest hesitation up front was, I mean, I just spent a lot of time praying through, am I, like, what is my time frame down here? You know, is it going to be long term? Am I purchasing a house? Am I leasing? Am I living by myself? Is that safe? Is that a prudent decision?
I was a young homeowner, and so had this house for several years, just like, what am I going to do with it? I don't want to sell it. I've only had it 6 years. I need to build, just this responsibility aspect that I felt.
Am I doing this in step with the Spirit's leading, and what does that actually look like?
Pouring into the residents and seeing them encouraged. And when they come to an event after a bad day at work, and then they leave smiling and happy, and they pull you aside and thank you for just spending time with them and listening to them, that's really encouraging.
Living for Christ, you know, it's so much more than just attending church, no matter how wonderful and enriching that church is. Mm-hmm. Unless you have a servant's heart, you aren't experiencing the fullness that Christ calls us to experience and blesses us with.
I mean, it really has opened up so many doors just by proximity. I feel like proximity has helped us engage more readily with this community and build deeper relationships and do things that we normally wouldn't be able to do just because we're, you know, 5 minutes down the road from them.
Honestly, that hasn't really been a risk at all, and or really a felt sacrifice at all. It's been such a blessing just to build a relationship with Carrie, the girl that I mentor, and just get to see her life change and just get to see how she's growing and how much she wants to kind of better her life and have goals.
So looking back, it's like all these things that I had thought about or considered or had to really spend some time working through and thinking about and lifting up, I mean, just, it's like it couldn't be in a better situation.
if the Lord is in our friendship or if the Lord is in the center of our decision, then it's not a risk. Like, He's going to take over the situation. He's sovereign, and He's going to work it out for our good and His.
When you put your sights on other people instead of thinking of yourself, it really helps you just grasp Christ's love for us even more so. You don't have to spend $3,000 and take off 2 weeks of work to go to Africa to spread the gospel, because it's right here in Dallas. I was one of them.
I think a lot of times we can discourage ourselves from serving that, oh, I'm not qualified, or I don't have the time, or I'm not any good at any of this, and turn serving into more of a resume. You know, do I meet these needs or do I meet these qualifications? But I think at the end of the day, if we're faithful just to show up, He'll take whatever we give and just blow that out of the water and just bring back such amazing results that it can only be His hand in the process.
As soon as we take that focus off of ourselves and we focus on Christ and how He, if we let Him just to use us to share His love with others, life is joyful. It's dramatically different. I'll never not be on mission again, ever.